I must open up by saying that I was pleasantly surprised by Member Kanyane, who serves with me in the Finance Committee. I was pleasantly surprised. Maybe surprised is the wrong word. I think shocked is more closer to what I felt. I mean, the 20-minute or longer speech that he gave us about initially land and all sorts of issues was a whole lot more than anything I've ever heard him say in the Finance Committee where he serves with me. He hardly ever has anything to say, so I'm quite surprised. Whoever prepared his speech, congratulations to you. Maybe try and prepare his speeches for finance, because that's where the real work is done, as you constantly always remind us. But in any event, his speech was riddled with hypocrisy. If he was allowed to digress, I must also be allowed to digress. Seeing as we don't have respect for consistency in this house, I shall follow in that tradition. His 20-minute speech was riddled with hypocrisy. I mean, you can't talk about the comprador and bourgeoisie classes to us. I mean, you can't lecture us about the comprador and bourgeoisies. We are not those people. We are not those people. We are poor people. And the constituencies that we represent are poorer than ourselves. And they are living under very dire conditions, which something I would have expected for him to focus on as a committee member coming from the governing party. Would have been, instead of wasting that 20 minutes, let me just advise you also, because I'm a public relations practitioner, so I write and do communication strategies for a living, besides this politics that I'm doing here. Let me advise you in future, please can you ask your committee members that instead of wasting 20 minutes of our time lecturing us about hypocrisies, of the hypocrisies that are actually demonstrated live in action, have been demonstrated live in action over the past 20 years by your own party, let them rather focus on the work that they are supposed to be doing in finance. We are already doing that. We've only been here 3 months. We've been here 3 months. We have no prior knowledge, as you constantly patronize us by telling us you are teaching us. I'm not sure what you're teaching us, because I think in finance I make a lot of substantial inputs, in fact, which we don't get from the ANC caucus. So, after that very poor attempt by Member Kanyane to brainwash us about how the ANC is representing the interests of the poor and is anti the bourgeoisie and the comprador class. They are the bourgeoisie, or rather, let me call them the petty bourgeoisie, and they are the comprador classes, because, by the way, babo manchingelane be capital. We know that. White monopoly capital and the ANC on this side are in partnership. That's a known fact. You are defending the interests of capital. You are defending the interests of the minority and the elite in this country. Stop lying to us. I asked you to do that the other day. I'm going to ask you again. So thanks for indulging me there. So as a parting shot, Member Kanyane, after his mambo jumbo about land and all sorts of things he knows very little about, he really assisted me and continued to surprise me. I was impressed. I must compliment him. When he decided to say, let me stop right there, or let me skip this, I don't know what he was talking about anyway. What was he skipping? But thank you for at least considering that he was boring us and he was not inspiring us. I get it, you are older, you guys. You are older than us and you are here to teach us. You must take that position of teaching as an honorable position and teach us things of substance. You're not teaching a substance. You have a podium here, you can speak, but you say things that are not actually enriching us intellectually. So let me come back to the MEC and stick to the topic this time. MEC, Chrissy, I have a lot of respect for you, not only because you're older than me, but it seems to me in this ANC caucus you're about the only person who doesn't seem to have some kind of scandal hanging over their head. So I'm hoping that except for protecting the capitalist class, which obviously that's the mandate you get from Luthuli House, I cannot stop you from doing that. But I must thank you for the point that you raised about the fact that I raised those issues under the finance vote, whereas I was supposed to raise it under treasury. So let me repeat it again, under treasury. Am I allowed? Sure. You advise me and I'm taking the advice. I'm showing you that I do listen. The 52.15% under expenditure in infrastructure. Let me repeat it for effect and for impact. You can't do that to poor people. You can't. You can't treat poor people like that. It's absolutely wrong. Let me repeat it again. The same infrastructure department, 19 out of 60 projects that they were supposed to deliver, they didn't deliver. You can't do that to poor people. Because what it does, you are actually creating a sense of false hope. You come in the beginning of the year, like next year you're supposed to give us your strategic plans for the government, right? You're going to take us through very painful processes of long speeches,
of radical transformation and all of that, and tell us that you're going to do A, B, C, D. And then I'm sitting there, I'm living in Zandspruit, I'm living in Diepsloot, with the hope that the sewage that's coming through my house is going to stop because of these infrastructure projects that you have promised me, and then you don't actually deliver them. Please, that's the point I really want to repeat under the correct subject heading. But what I really want to caution, maybe before I caution the MEC, you also mentioned that the PIVA model is very perfect and it's exemplary and it's all these beautiful things. Okay, maybe I've been here for 3 months and I'm still yet going to go on that journey for the next 5 years and experience how perfect PIVA is. But I must tell you that my intuition is telling me that I doubt that it's perfect. In fact, I think that its proximity to perfection is probably this much and perfection is here. So, on the basis of that oversight model, I want to ask the MEC, before the MEC lectures us new people and all of that in this house.
Thank you. Thank you. Time up. No, that's the time up. You don't have free time. You don't have. Mashiko, you don't have free time.
Mashiko,
is our talent over my job. I'm tired of you.